I'll now request Shri Ajay Data to spend a few minutes talking about both cyber security and also about the language enablement that we need to do as a country.
Thank you very much, sir. It's a proud, privileged moment for me to share the dais with you and speak to this august guardians. As you know, sir said that I could got an opportunity to represent from Asia Pacific, especially India, to be part of ICANN leadership in two places, in CCNSO Council and USG chairmanship. Both are, one is elected, one is selected. So I will talk about the languages. We heard about a lot of applications, a lot of enterprise architectures, a lot of cloud services, and here is what I want to caution. One thing which sir has requested me to do is making them compatible with languages. The internet is changing. Internet is adopting the new top-level domain names, which are going to be available in your languages, which means in the days to come, in 2020, all of us will be in position to register a top-level domain name in a language of your choice and the word of your choice, which means I would be able to register a top-level domain name .ajay in Hindi or .ajay in Assamese. Top-level domain name, those who do not know, is the right side after the dot, just like .com, just like .in, just like I can have .ajay in Hindi. So let us say I have a .ajay in Hindi, and now I can obviously have an email address on the domain name. So once I have a domain name and an email address, can I subscribe to that service which you are creating now? Can you register my contact record in your application? The answer is most of the applications, not just in India, globally fail. This is a universal acceptance issue. If you are more keen about understanding it, please search on universal acceptance issue. You will know global companies, including Apple, Google, Microsoft, Facebook, and everybody else globally are working on it, which I am chairman of that committee. If around 400 IT professionals are there. This is a global bug which has been left while not considering this future of internet, and now they do not accept. They make every valid domain name and valid email address as invalid. So what I want to consider and sir here, that make universal acceptance as a procurement policy, as a procurement guideline. So when a cloud service provider comes online or a software developer comes online, he must ensure that he is UA ready. If he is user ready, you are then making a future-proof application. Otherwise, we will get into the situation where we have a IP device being bought today, but which is not IPv6 compatible. And then we think that we are not going to use that device in future, and the investment gone bad. So the situation is to be UA ready. All of applications which you have now, you can have UA ready. If you want to try out the email address and get it free, so there is an app called Datamail, D-A-T-A-M-A-I-L. It can give you a free email address. Get an email address and try out in your applications if it works or not for you. This is a fantastic opportunity to build your applications UA ready and move further. Another thing I want to talk about languages is there was a panel which was created, which CDAC from the government part participated, around 70 volunteers from all over country, those who created the rules for the languages so that the phishing attacks are not there, the confusability is not there, what was left as a part of ASCII system is no more there in the new language system. Internet 4.0 is getting built where the language barriers are being broken, which means a person who do not know English at all or do not prefer to speak in English would be able to surf the internet and use internet as powerfully, as good as we can here. This is the power of which is being built by Neo Brahmi Generation Panel. The work is on the rules which has been created by Indian community along with the help of Bangladesh, Nepal and Sri Lanka has gone into the root zone. They have become part of the root servers of the internet, and soon this is going to be live and for all of us will be able to use it. This is all from language point. Now I will come to my presentation for cybersecurity. So internet is not owned by anyone. By 2016, it was owned or kind of controlled by US government. The IANA transition happened. Now it is completely governed and controlled by community. You can participate, so I can. I am participating from my own interest. A lot of people from India participate. That's not a large number, but I would encourage everyone to participate. But this is a hostile environment. Because nobody owns it, we can only govern the policies. So everybody is free to do anything we like to. So we have the continuous attacks all over. When we see news every day that there is something, some breach, some cheat, some password leak, something is happening every day. So it becomes a very hostile environment. We almost trust on password. I am guaranteeing you, cannot find out if your email account is being accessed right now by somebody else. There is no way you can find out. Because the trust is only on a password. A password with some numerical alphabets. For all the applications, this is true. There are no mechanisms to track them. Third is OTP is a second level, which works. And we also know that the phone gets hacked and OTP also gets taken over now. So this is also getting a compromised situation right now we are in. So we need to also think that we have some more solid mechanism where we are not dependent on something which can be still taken away in spite of I am relying on that OTP, which is a second level of protection. Next slide, please. So you can see Trojans, viruses, malwares, this is everyday life. Everybody gets suffered. We do not know, nobody can guarantee if your PC or a mobile phone is not compromised right now. There is no way you can find that out. Till somebody do not pop up a window and ask you money, or somebody damages you. So there are many people who is interested just in data. This is great for them to compromise your PC and keep getting the data. And you wonder how this my contact list has gone away. How come this mail I was not talking about to anybody is also already leaked. How do you know about all that stuff? These are something which are very, very scary, and we need to really have a framework where we are able to deal with them and know that you are compromised. Network must be prepared. We are creating large network going up to the panchayat level. And we also know the reality that we are not going to get the best of the brains at the rural level. So we need a centralized plan. So I say this, I wrote a recently an article, just like sir, Ajay sir, I want to mention you this, just like we have an army, armed forces for land, for air, for water, we need for digital infrastructure. And this is something which we need to start building. This is something which we need to think. Just like all of us do not have a watchman at our home, why we need to require a firewall? Why not the network, the IS connectivity given to me by my connectivity provider is already secured, already taken care, already some mechanisms are done that I am being tracked, I am being attacked, I have been compromised. Can I get something out of it? If we have best brain and create an army around it, the whole country can be safeguarded. Next slide, please. Protect data. I heard few years before, I read an article. I was very, very happy in the morning when I read this news. Government bans Gmail for official work. This was an order, and this is not implemented order. I received many, many emails from almost all the government officials use still Gmail. This is okay. But let us say this order is implemented in totality. But we are shifted on WhatsApp. So there's no difference. Rather more dangerous. We end up shifting everything on the public cloud again, which is not yours. So we have an NIC infrastructure, which is there available, which ensures the data is within India under the legal parameters, under the government scrutiny. And now the thing is again in a parallel environment gone out. So we need to also look at something that we have our own communication mechanism and the entire data is within the government premises. Next slide, please. Call logs and chat data. As I already said, we have telecom companies. They are licensed. They are supposed to maintain every log. They are supposed to maintain every damn thing for us. What about WhatsApp? What about Skype? I can do the exactly similar function which I can do with my phone. We need to really address this kind of situation, which is again a security threat. Somebody need not to, you know, only click a picture of a secure document. He can read it out on a WhatsApp and gone, and everything gone. You need not to just take out a picture or capture the whole document. So nobody knows the call has happened and the data has gone. And even the people with bad intentions must be using this kind of infrastructure, and I think we need to be really careful about. Next slide, please. Secured India. And sir, this is one thing which, if I can leave this mission today with all of you, can we have a mission that this country is going to be man in middle attack free? And it is simple to do, sir. Sanjeev ji gave an excellent presentation about cloud. One thing I would request to mandate is no cloud service provider will host a non-SSL API. Fundamental. If we can have this rule in this country that no API will be hosted without SSL, and you will not access any host without SSL, you are talking about zero attacks which are done by man in middle. What is man in middle? I will take a minute to explain. You have a phone right now and you have a Wi-Fi right now. If you are accessing any website or any email server or any chat server through you without SSL, the service provider right now, which is NKN, can see all of your passwords, can see all of your emails. And you need not to tell anybody. This is simply loggable. You have to just log the traffic. That's it. That is man-in-middle attack. So, and then if I can see it, I can change it. So which means you sent an email to somebody else and I read that email, I can change that email and send something else. That is really a man-in-middle attack. Another man-in-middle attack is you browsed a website which is not SSL. What content came from there? The content came from PMO, let us say, for example, though it is a secured site, let us consider for a second it is non-secured. The content came from there, man-in-middle changes the content and shows you something else. That is man-in-middle attack. We have to have guaranteed SSL security as a mandate for everyone, for all the APIs, for all the transactions, for all the websites. And if Government of India decides, and we all of us have to work together on this, decides that we are going to be in 2021, 2020 December, we are going to raise our flag with middle attack free, we can achieve this. We'll be the first country in the world to achieve it. It is very much possible. Next slide, please. Step to protect call logs. I already talked about this. This has already happened. This we are already seeing. But what we are doing, so already I saw a news again, government decides to tighten process of accessing phone call records. This is law for telecom companies. They pay license, they are everything. But nothing is being done, there are many things which are outside our scope. We are not able to tackle them. And I think as a senior citizen in the country, I think that we need to really address and keep ourselves secured from and monitoring and ensuring that all the logs are available to the security agencies or whomsoever we want to. Next slide, please. Protect email. Again, sir, this is linked with the man-in-middle attack only. If you are having an email accessed through your computer or a phone, and in that, the red boundary, if you are accessing your IMAP through 143 or 110 on SN port 25, you can imagine you are vulnerable. You are right, it is possible to track your password and track your email right now. This, if you are using it right now, you are not aware that you are under track. Your emails are read, your passwords are read, everything is possible. Today, if you can see that, go back and check your computers in your Outlook Express or Thunderbird or on your mobile if you have configured your email, if this is using these ports. If this is using ports, shut it down today and change it to, I have the answer to that. Change it to 993, 995 and these ports, or your service provider will tell you how to make it secure. If the service provider cannot do it, please switch the service provider now before it becomes too much for you. Next slide, please. Securing India. Sir, I already told in the early that we have these many people in our armed forces, millions of people. We don't need millions of people in digital security. We need hands of hundreds of people to build this army here, which can really be top brains of the world. And we have these people in the country. If we galvanize them together, put them as an army here, we can really create a secure nation. We are becoming a haven for spammers. People are hosting, taking a broadband connection, hosting unsecured IP, and just start creating spam. Our networks get blacklisted globally. We lose the reputation. And that is where we need to really ensure that every single IP is accounted for every single IP is known what is doing, every single IP, as a government, we know this, we exist in India, and why it is being used, who is using it, and then this entire architecture can really be a dashboard for you to available that this task force, this armed force, which is digital task force, can bring this on our table. Next slide, please. 2.7 billion units in India by 2020. Almost all of us, sir, have a TV, a smart TV in our room, and we have smart IoT devices. All of them almost are unsecured. All of them. Lot of people can see their home from here, unsecured, just protected by password. We need to really, really see that all the devices are secured. Next slide, please. And that's all for last slide from me. You can't secure what you can't see. That's the message. Please note that whatever is happening on the network, you can see it. Be aware, protect it, monitor it, and audit it continuously to have a secured India in ourselves. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ajay ji, for a very fresh look, a very interesting look, both at the various kinds of vulnerabilities that we live with today and also the possible solutions. Thank you. Now we move on to the last presentation. This is by Shri K. Vikram from HPE, and he will be talking about smart data centers, sustainable public Wi-Fi, and digital as a service.